Hi. So my name is Jocelyn, and today I'm walking by faith and doing what God's asked me to do. So I just want to say thank you, first of all, for even clicking on this video. I hope that it, the intentions are revealed to you and that you get what you need out of it. So I'm a hairstylist. It's what I do. I'm really good at makeup. It's definitely been something that I've had to practice and get the hang of to learn how to do. But I think I'm pretty good at it now. So I'm just gonna get ready and I'm gonna talk to y'all as I'm getting ready. So I've already washed my face, but I'm just gonna kind of go through and do my skincare real quick because that's just like a big thing for me. I'm like crazy about my skin. You have to forgive me because I'm kind of, my allergies are like acting up. So I've been like clearing my throat a lot and kind of sneezy. So hopefully I can make it through this without like having a sneeze attack. And I don't have a lot of time today. So this is kind of a little intro video, I guess, because God did some amazing things last night. And I'm really just trying to walk in obedience because I can't go back to the old Jocelyn. And I'll talk more about that as we get to know each other. But, you know, God loves you. He really does. And it doesn't matter where you come from, who you are, what you've been through, what you've done, who you've hurt. Jesus came and got on that cross so that you don't have to worry about any of the past things that you did. And that's the greatness of God. That's how you see the glory of God, is being able to go broken and hurting and just a mess like I was to him and just say, Lord, here I am. Make me clean. Make me new. Make me fresh. And he will. And, you know, some of you may know, some of you may not. I'm a transgender woman. I struggled a lot in the past with my identity and how that relates to my relationship with Christ. In the end, what I've come to conclude, through much agony on myself, which he says you don't have to carry that. I was trying to be something that I wasn't, something that he didn't create me to be. I know that's a whole nother thing for people, and I don't want to get in that today. I just want to talk about the goodness and how amazing he is, and how amazing he's been to me, as much as I can in this little short video. God has been after me for so long, guys, to be a voice for my generation, for my community. And I fought that for so long. And I kept going back over and over and over to the things that in my flesh felt good, right? The things that I knew that I could go to at any time and instantly feel better, you know? And that's the thing with our walk with Christ, is that we have to walk by faith, you know? And what does the word say about faith? It says faith comes by believing, not by seeing, you know? A lot of us try to, I feel like, bargain with God and say to him, you know, well, if you do this for me, I'll do this for you. And that's not really how it goes. Like, if you are convicted about something and it's just like getting you, and it's something that nags at you, and when you're doing it, you don't feel like great about it, especially if you're in this surrender place where, like, I'm at, you get a conviction in your heart, and you know that it's not something that you should be doing. The song is such a good song. Anyway, so I guess let's just start with me from when I was 17, well, 16. I was a part of a church, a baby mega church, I guess, in the making. It had a pretty large congregation when I quit going. But I had felt a really strong pull towards the worship ministry. And I fought that, like I fight everything when it comes to what God wants me to do. I just am I will do better when it comes to that. It's a faith walk, right? When I tried out for choir, I remember going in the little room and being told, okay, we'll sing for us. And I'm like, hey, what do you want me to sing? And I'm like, well, just any worship song, any worship song. And I'm like, well, at that time, you know, I was going to the church for clarity on what I was feeling, because, you know, at that time I really was struggling with how I was feeling. You know, at that point I thought, oh, I'm just a gay guy and that's, you know, how I'm supposed to live my life. But a lot of that was hijacked by the fact that I was being told that to be gay is a sin and that I'm gonna go to hell and that I need to change and be who God made me to be. And that was just a constant struggle for me, you know? And anyway, I just knew that I felt Jesus when I was there and I heard him and I wanted to continue to hear him. So I just, I kept going there, and there happened to be a day, you know, after I had been on the worship team for a while, and in the choir, there happened to be a particular message this day where they told us that we were only going to sing one time that day. And normally we would always do two services, and we had to stay when you're on the worship team. You had to stay for both services, which, I mean, I was on fire for the Lord back then, so I could be in church all day back then. It's not a big deal. I was just kind of like weirded out that, you know, they had said we're only going to have one service today. So anyway, get on the stage, sing, get off the stage, come down. Since it was just one service, I had decided that, oh, I'm just going to sit with my mom, because typically I would stay with the choir for the first service, and then I would sit with my family for the second service, because that was the one that they would come to. And so I find my mom, I go, I sit down with her, and it was interesting, because when I walked into the sanctuary, the screens, the huge screens that they had in there, said that today's message was going to be kind of a sensitive one, and they were really encouraging people to go put their children, if they had them, with them in the kid zone thing, so that, you know, there wouldn't be any interruption of the spirit as the message was being delivered. And I was just like, this is weird. So I sit down, and this was right before Texas had its first vote for gay marriage. And Pastor gets up there and starts to speak. And he said, you know, there are pigs, and there's the mud that the pigs roll around in. Homosexuals are the mud, and God hates filth. And when he said that, I was so angry and hurt that I started to get up and leave. And my mom grabbed me and pulled me and said, you're here for a reason, you need to sit down. And, you know, she's come a long way since then. She's one of my biggest champions. You know, she didn't know. She's constantly has apologized to me for that over and over, for that day. But I was there for a reason, because I needed to hear that, so that I could go through what I went through in the subsequent years to realize that that's not true. It's not. This is crazy, but I left my powder in my purse, so let me grab it real quick. Enjoy the music, you know? The music's great, right? So, anyway, I was really on fire for God at that time, and it was hard for me to kind of imagine a world where my God hated me. And, you know, I was only listening to worship music at that time. I really wasn't like cussing anymore, or all the things that I thought that I shouldn't be doing, that people tell us that we shouldn't be doing, which, whatever, I'm not here to tell you what you need to do or don't need to do. When you hear God and he convicts you, you know what you're doing is wrong, if it's something that you should be doing, if that makes sense. I'm sure it does, because, you know, he's God. Anyway, I stayed at a church for a long time, and that was just something that I struggled with, because I knew that I had such a strong connection to him and hearing him at that time, that I couldn't believe that you know what that pastor was saying about, you know, God thinking I'm disgusting, you know. It hurt. It was a scar. I mean, it still is. Anyway, the reason why that was something that really was so hard for me was because I got saved in that church. I accepted Christ in that church. So, and I had never had any negative things happen to me while I had been going there. As far as anybody ever saying anything to me, I mean, it was very apparent that I was super gay. But nobody ever said anything to me. I did invite friends who, you know, were a couple and to the church and told them just how amazing it was because I hadn't had anything negative happen to me that they should come, you know. And unfortunately, somebody felt like it was their place to say to them that they were an abomination, which that when that happened, oh my gosh, that was before the whole sermon on gay marriage. Anyway, that just hurt me because, you know, I never would wanted to hurt any of my friends or have them experience something like that. I would have told them to come because I felt like I was being affirmed in a way, which obviously I wasn't. But you know, when I got saved there, it was a Resurrection Sunday. And the altar call was gigantic. I mean, there was so many people there, y'all. And back then, you know, I think they thought, oh, brown person, let's put them with a brown person. So they put me with this lady that only spoke Spanish. I know I'm brown. I am Latina. Pero no hablo español. Not very well. So, yeah. She took me to the back with her. And, you know, it was a whole, like, you know, they give you, like, this little packet. And they give you a Bible. And they pray with you. And my aunt's husband had given his life to the Lord that morning as well. And I saw her back there and I was like, hey, I don't, can you please help me translate what she's saying? Because I don't understand what she's saying. And my aunt talks to her and the lady tells her that she wants to pray for me. So she prays in Spanish, felt the presence of the Lord. It was amazing. And even though I didn't understand not a thing she was saying. And after she had gotten done praying, she started telling my aunt in Spanish that she wanted a Bible because the Lord had given her a scripture in the spirit that was over my life. And she kept saying it over and over and over in Spanish. And I did not understand what she was saying. But gave her a Bible, and she flipped to it. And when I read it, I thought, this is a good one, you know? Like, I wasn't quite sure at that point, like, what it, like, let me just say, I don't know what, I didn't know then what I know now, to know that that scripture is for my life. I mean, it's Isaiah 54:17. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Every tongue that rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and your righteousness is from me, says the Lord. He called me to serve him back then. And, you know, my little 16-year-old self was like, oh, I got a cool little scripture, you know, like, and when I turned 18, I tattooed it on my arm. I'll show y'all one day. I'm really trying not to be inappropriate because I literally just woke up and God was like, make a video, like, do it. So, I'm trying to be very modest. But anyway, just, guys, when I say to you, he hears you, he loves you, he wants you to come to him and talk to him and give him all of your worries and all of your problems and all your anxiety, all your depression, all your sadness. He wants you to give it to him. He wants you to give it to him. He doesn't want you to hold on to that stuff. He doesn't want you to carry it around. He doesn't want you to carry around that shame that you have inside of you that you think that you have to hold on to, that says that you're something that you're not. You're a child of God. You're beloved. You're beloved. And if you could just hold on to that promise, that he'll carry you through. I promise you, he will not drop you. He won't let you down. I know that it's scary when you're going through things and you feel like he's not there with you. But I want you all to remember. There's a scripture in Mark, it's Mark 11, verse 24, that therefore I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you have received it and it will be yours. It's right here. It's right here. I have it kind of highlighted, well, underlined, because I misplaced my good highlighter. So I'm like lightly with the pen anyway. I really want to recommend to y'all, get a Bible. Like, get a word that you can touch and that you can carry around with you. I know that there are so many resources out there, and I'm going to see if I can link some to this for anybody who may not have a Bible, so we can try and figure out a way to get you one. But anyway, it's really important. This right here, this is your food. This is your nourishment. This is your weapon against anything that comes up against you. Anything. And believe me, people will take this word, this holy word, and try and twist it and try and make it something that it's not. And believe me, this is a love letter. This is a love letter to let you know that he loves you just as you are. And believe me, I know that people can take certain parts of it and make it something that it's not. And, you know, I'm not a Bible scholar, but I know enough to know that the context of certain verses and the way that they were written and the way that people decide they're going to cherry pick things and say, oh, well, this is wrong, but this is okay. You know, like, times have changed. It's okay to eat shellfish. Well, boo boo. If he said the same thing about shellfish that he said about laying with a man, blah, 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 a man should not lay with a man, none of y'all will be having these crab boils and shrimp boils and all that. You know, I love crab legs, so don't. But look, I had to do this little video, and I hope it made sense, and I hope that it helped somebody. I know I felt like I was kind of rambling for a bit, but God wanted me to get on here to just say that you're loved, that he hears you, he knows you, he knew you before he formed you. It's been written. It's Nothing about you is a mistake. Nothing about you is happenstance. Nothing in your life just happens to happen. All of our steps are ordered. The surrender is hard. It really is. I know it's hard. Giving it to him and saying, Lord, I trust you with this. It's hard. I know it's hard. I struggle every day. even right now, I struggle. But like I said, the old Jocelyn wasn't somebody who was glorifying God to her best. And I would get little tugs here and there about, you know, him wanting me to be removed from a place or a thing or a person. And I would stay because it made me feel good. It made me feel, I could feel it good. And I realized that it wasn't until I really took a look. Well, he took everything from me. He did. And he will. And you hear that all the time. I mean, let me tell you. Nobody is exempt from pain. Nobody is exempt from suffering. But it's what we do with that pain. It's what we do with that suffering. It's who we go to with it to get our strength. That really will propel us forward in our walk with Christ. Remember that he's faithful, just like this song says. I really encourage you, when you're having a tough day, when you're having a tough moment, just put on a worship song. Just get to a place, if you can, that's quiet, and just ask him to speak to you. I promise you, he will always come through. He will always. And I know we can get into this too on another video about how, you know, we can ask God for signs. And at least for me, I ask God for signs, and I'll get them. And then I'll be like, okay, God, but if you can give me another one. I did that with this, whether or not to do this video, because my biggest thing is like having people like try and say that I'm crazy, because I think I hear God. I know I hear God. I know that he sees me. I know that he hears me. And I know that he loves me just how I am. So that's my purpose, and I'm accepting it to tell everybody, Jesus loves you just as you are. So anyway, I hope you all have a great day. I have got to get off now and get dressed for work. Just I hope you have a amazing day, and this is hopefully the first of many. I'm hoping, obviously, to, as time goes on, to, you know, be a little bit more polished in my delivery. But, anyway, thank you guys for checking this out. Hope you have a great day. Be blessed.